Good morning. Good morning, family. A truly beautiful day today. So shiny, cool, refreshing, almost perfect. I would like to thank all of you who are listening, all of you who are sharing these videos, all of you who start seeing this inside of you, this something that it's undescribable yet. I feel it and I'm so happy, so tremendously joyful. Thank you. Today it's a kind of, you know, average subject, and you'll see, by dedication, it's dedicated to Barack Obama and Vladimir Putin, and we will include all the present leaders of this world, of 253 countries. Thank you, dear one. Thank you. The subject is very average, I say. Talks about a leadership. And title goes like this. Excuse me. Who's a true leader of this new world? Okay, so new world is here, as you noticed. Don't believe me? Okay. Now sit and wait. But the true world is really here. Because at the moment, what we have in leadership of the countries, we have people who are, well, we have a leadership of the countries and leadership of the spiritual organizations, let's say, or religion organizations. We have people who are not willing to engage in conflict any longer. That's the biggest achievement of us as a humanity. We basically grew in the last couple of years from a teenager into delinquent adolescent. Okay, I kind of, you know, have a funny feeling about this, how we don't need the jails anymore, but we still need a very detailed guidance. Then we don't go again in our, you know, who is right, who is better, who has more weapons. A really beautiful transformation is happening in the last couple of years. And you'll see it more and more. Because what we have now in leadership, from Pope, Putin, Obama, Merkel, if you pick, they're all becoming very non-aggressive. Do you understand how? I just feel them. They've changed. Maybe their rhetorics were before like this, but not anymore. Let's say if you go in the past, just 50, 60 years, how Gandhi was leading others. By his example, and expressing his idea through his actions, okay, of non-violence, of equality for all, how Martin Luther King was doing this. So in one case, they were not leaders, they're just an example. And now we're seeing more and more in the present time where Putin do the same, Obama do the same, but they are in a very tough task where complete society of our, let's say, human civilization is transforming into from non-aggressive, from very aggressive, very selfish, very materialistic, into something, let's call it less or more intuitive, more willing to understand this is the way of coexistence with everything, nature, other beings, other civilizations. So we first have to clear our, let's call it disputes in our heads between races here. Are you black? Are you white? Are you Serbian? Are you a Croatian or whatever? Orthodox? Are you Catholic? So either you are Lebanese or Israeli. You still speak the same language. You still look alike. So why differences? And when you see in leadership of the present countries, they actually start transmuting into somebody who actually looks about ways to help others more than show the finger how other is different than you, or you're better than the other, or your borders are actually just up to here and you will not take any refugees, and you will, this is the point where the big transformation starts happening. This refugee wave that is happening now, it's amazing. I mean, amazing opportunity for all the, let's call it Western or border Western countries, to realize they can truly help for the first time. Help from their own heart. And you can see people start showing their governments how to behave. They start taking people, the refugees, in their house, in the homes. Pope Francis announced he'll give three, like a cemeteries for refugees in Italy. So this started. So I hope, and you will see that the other religious groups will do the same, whatever, you know, per country, based on his example. This is a true leader, what, let's say, Pope did it. Okay. When you start noticing, then mortality starts destroying itself. So let's say we start living much longer. This becomes an indication that we start transmuting all our old angers, all our old disagreements, disapproval of each other. We become more friendlier. By becoming more friendlier, we're becoming more, you know, our longevity becomes extended. Definitely we'll become more healthier. I have another nice one I want to read. Do you want to be a hero in the graveyard or a genius creator alive? Only these two choices. Do you want to be a hero, dead one, or a genius creator who still lives? You don't have a third choice. You cannot sit on the sidelines and wait who's going to win. You have to be the one of these two. So heroes go to war. What a creator do? Create opportunities. Cares for others. Learn how to practice its own intuition. learns how to develop his own creativity, his own genius in whatever. Genius can be whatever. So to answer on this silly question, who is a true leader of this new world, I would say it's joy that you bring to others. It's gratefulness towards Mother Father who gave you this wonderful energy of life. The true leader of this new world is care that you have for others. True leader is this inner light within you.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them blue for me and you, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world.